In this video, I'll demonstrate how to draw in parallel perspective in Corel Designer to create objects with a 3D appearance. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also find a written version of this tutorial. There are two toolbars that aren't displayed by default that I'll be using for my examples. Toolbars can be toggled on and off by right-clicking in any existing toolbar, and I'll display Drawing Planes and Transform. To demonstrate the difference between 2D drawing and parallel perspective drawing, I'll choose View, Grid, Document Grid. I'm in orthographic or 2D drawing mode, so the grid is the familiar square blocks. When I click the Rectangle tool and draw a rectangle, it's a 2D rectangle in orthographic view. When I assign dimensions in the Transform toolbar, equal dimensions will produce a square. To switch to parallel perspective drawing, I'll be using the red top, blue front, and green right icons in the Drawing Planes toolbar. The default drawing profile is the commonly used isometric, but I could switch to other preset profiles, including several dimetric and trimetric, or I could create and save my own profile. Clicking the Projected Axes Docker icon opens that Docker, which has the same options as the Drawing Planes toolbar, as well as some additional features. I'll now draw a box in parallel perspective. To draw the left or front side of the box, I'll click the blue plane, either on the toolbar or in the Docker. The document grid updates to reflect this plane, and when I create a rectangle and set its dimensions, the rectangle adheres to this plane at the correct size. If I return to orthographic view by clicking the icon in the Drawing Planes toolbar or by clicking away from the cube in the Docker, the dimensions of the rectangle update to reflect the size of its bounding box in 2D. To continue with the right side of the box, I'll click the green plane and draw the rectangle to start at the lower corner of the first rectangle. To match the height, I could enter a value in the Transform toolbar, or I can hover over a corner node whose position I want to reference and use the dotted guideline to set the rectangle height. To complete the box, I'll switch to the top plane and fit the rectangle to its opposite corners. And to clear the display, I'll turn off the grid. Objects drawn in 2D can be projected onto any of the three planes. The current view is orthographic, and I have a text object I want to place on the right side of the box. With the Pick tool, I'll select the text, and while holding the Shift key, I'll click the green plane. Now that the text is projected onto the plane I want, I can move the projected text into place. For this new parallel perspective drawing, I could set my own drawing profile by expanding the Docker and changing angle and scale values in the three directions, and the preview cube updates to reflect the changes. There are also options to bookmark or save a custom drawing profile. But for this drawing, I'll use a trimetric preset. To start drawing, I'll activate the two-point line tool, set the green front plane for drawing, and while I'm drawing, guidelines appear so that I can follow the orientation of the plane I'm drawing in. As we saw earlier, I can reference other nodes by hovering over them first, and this time I'm looking for guide intersection points. This is the front of the object, and the back will be along the x-axis. So, with the object still selected, in the Move Along Axis section of the Docker, I'll set the copy distance along x, make one copy, and click Apply. Now I can connect the two objects by adding lines between corner nodes. This is how the object would look in wireframe view. But if I want the appearance of a solid object, I can use the Virtual Segment Delete tool to remove segments of lines that wouldn't be visible in a solid. I can then use the Smart Fill tool to fill in the curves. A common technique in classic technical illustration is to assign thick lines to outer edges and thin lines to inner edges. Think of a worm crawling around an object. Everywhere the worm would disappear from view should have a thick edge. The properties of these two types of edges are set in the Object Styles Docker. For the thick line style, I have a high width and red color, and thin lines are about half as wide as thick ones and are blue. Objects including lines and curves, rectangles, circles, ellipses, and the tools in the Thread tool group support thick and thin lines. I'll start with a rectangle in the red plane and click the Thick and Thin Lines icon in the property bar. This rectangle will be the bottom of the box, so the thick lines should be in front. To switch thick and thin, I'll click the Reverse Line Width icon. If I were to assign a fill color, the thick and thin lines will disappear, so I'll leave it unfilled. In the projected axes docker, I'll make one copy of this rectangle in the Y direction and switch thick and thin, since the back edges will be the outside edges. Now I can complete the connecting lines, and the outer two should be thick. I can either use the Reverse Line Width icon for a selected line, or go back to the Object Styles docker and apply the style I want to the selected object. To add a new object to the front of this box, I can simply activate the correct plane and draw. This time I'll draw on the blue plane, add a circle, and copy the circle in the negative Z direction. I'll connect the two circles between the points where thick and thin meet, make the new lines thick, and delete all unseen segments. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on parallel perspective drawing in Corel Designer. If you've been watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also find a written version of this tutorial.